So about a year ago, I was reading this latest book from one of my favorite authors named Glennon Doyle, and the book was called Untamed. And I had been a fan of Glennon's for many years reading her memoirs, but this one stood out to me as being the most honest, the most vulnerable. And the phrase that Glennon used over and over in this memoir was held and free. And she used that to describe the ideal feeling of being in a relationship. So when she met her partner, Abbie, she felt like she had the freedom to be who she truly was, but also the security to know that she was loved for who she was. And I think oftentimes we can feel ourselves needing to fold in parts of ourselves that aren't accepted by everyone, or to cut off our sharp edges so that we fit in either with a church or in a relationship or societal expectations. But the ideal is being able to be truly yourself, be both held and free. And so I had just finished reading that in Untamed when I went to have a writing session with my friends and thought, isn't that the kind of relationship I want to have with God? One where I feel held, secure, known, loved, but also completely free. There are no parts of me that I have to cut off in order to feel like I'm worthy of love from God. So that started this song called Held and Free. And from the first line, I knew the direction it would go. I'm not a captive, but I'm captivated by you. And that's the kind of love that was inspiring in this story, and the kind of love I want to have with God.
I'm not a captive, but I'm captivated by you. Your love surrounds me, the walls that came down are the proof. Once I was lost, it's true. Now I'm just lost in you. I am held and I am free. What a beautiful mystery. captivated by you. Your love surrounds me, the walls that came.